There's something that happens when you see something that you've been working on digitally, and then you see it and you hold it for the first time in your hands. It's like magic being born. And there's something that really happens. It comes to life in front of you. My name is Jared Krichevsky. I'm a creature and character designer at Aaron Sims Creative. My experience actually came from character, from the theater and from the stage. Got my degree in acting, a minor in film study and fine art. And I kept coming across these digital art masters books. I was blown away by the level of skill that was required to create these pieces of art. And I said, man, I gotta learn how to do this. Some of the dream projects that I've gotten to work on have been like Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, Pete's Dragon, and coming up as Ready Player One. Here I was, you know, working on the projects that I always loved, even in some small way influencing them. My involvement is usually in the conceptual stage. So look development, figuring out what these creatures and characters look like, how do we imbue these creatures with personality that makes them come alive on the screen. When you see them come to life, it's magic. There is definitely a difference between like physical and digital when collaborating on something. With 3D modeling and 3D sculpting, you can push design to levels that you couldn't do in physical media because it has physical limitations. But with digital, there are no limitations. Now we could specifically define how thick our models were, how hollow they were. When you're digitally sculpting, there's a bit of separation between you and the subject. You are working on a screen, you're staring at a screen. When I saw the 3D printing was coming into play, I kept my eye on the various projects and printers that were coming out. When I saw the Form 2 and I saw the prints that were coming out of it, I went, this is it. Finally, we can push the detail as much as we want. Everything I put into it, I get out. When it's in your hands and it's real, it's really special. That last final print where the design is set, we use that because it's definitely a selling point for the producers and the directors. They can hold it in their hands and say, wow, this is our design. This is what it has to do. And if they're holding it in their hands, they can shoot the lighting reference off of that and use that, you know, for visual effects supervisors. If they can see it, if they can hold it, then they can plan better for it. The revolution that's happening with 3D printing and 3D software, it's exponential. When you combine 3D printing with all of these technologies coming together, I think in the next 10, 15 years, the world we're looking at right now is going to be radically different.